So I've actually got an iBeacon attached to my cat.
Ruby is alive. Ruby's not going anywhere.
Oh, I want to dream for developer happiness.
So I'm going to talk about Elixir, and I try to do it in 5 minutes. So basically, I'm talking about Elixir specifically by a Rubist to other Rubists. I don't know if you check it out about the new technology that is coming on and all these new devices and all these new things, but the future is actually really dynamic. There's a lot of things going on, and all these new devices and new technologies are focusing on being dynamic, on having information all the time, everywhere. And this is actually being supported by our hardware. So if you check Moore's Law, it's really like stroking us again and again, getting our processing power, doubling it every 2 years and so, and it's really awesome. For example, if you check my MacBook, this MacBook that I have here, I have 1 billion and 400 million transistors on it. What is awesome, like, you would never imagine that just like 5 years ago. And most impressive than that is not only the number of transistors that we have, but in the space that they are compacted. So all those transistors are in like 177 square millimeter space. What is really awesome. So why we have all this hardware power? Though this is basically the second thing about the future, because the future is concurrent. Not only concurrent, but the future is parallel. So all those new devices, all those new technologies, all those new like dynamic scenario that is coming are expecting like concurrency applications, are expecting parallel applications, that it's about processing a lot of files, processing a lot of requests, and giving it back to users at really amazing speeds. But in order to talk about that, we need to understand more about threads, process, and cores, what is awesome because he just explained it. So I can skip those slides and not talking anything about it. We can talk about mood-thread, and you just have like a really simple view about how doing mood-thread on Ruby. It is not that simple. You might feel really discomforted about doing my thread on Ruby. And actually, I don't even have to tell you how it's going to finish it, because we know that MRI can't handle really, really well parallelism and some kinds of concurrency. But there's something that can, and this thing is Elixir. How many of you have heard about Elixir before? Nice. So Elixir have its own virtual machine, like JVM, that it's our whole virtual machine built around mood process and concurrency process. So it has a whole new implementation about how process works, how thread works, just to handle like multi-processing and all this stuff. And it runs a language called Erlang that's really awesome as well, that basically empowered all the innovation on telecom and OTP things for the last 30 years. And that's really fun because they have a lot of great libraries and great code writing in the last 30 years. So a friend of mine called Jose Valim, there's a Brazilian, actually came up with idea, what about take Ruby, mix it up with Erlang virtual machine and put some steroids on it, and then he came up with Elixir. And it's really awesome. So Elixir enables you to do all this functional and concurrent stuff using your Erlang virtual machine and all this innovation for the last 30 years in really simple syntax, something really similar to Ruby. But in order to accomplish parallelism, it has to be functional. So I could go over functional stuff. So a lot of people like to talk about, all right, first class functions, or tail-call optimization, or map, or reduce, or recursivity, or whatever. But a functional is something like really simple. Basically, if you have to sum functional implementation in one sentence, it would be, it can update variables that are out of that scenario and can depend on variables that are out of that scenario. So the example that he gave was really good. So basically, you're sharing memory, so you can share the status and the value of variables that are outside the functions. Some really quick examples. So this would be a Ruby implementation, usual thing, everyone does it, but it's not functional because you're depending on an external variable. So the functional version of it, it's gonna be this. You receive the variable as an argument and then you plus it. Another example, really simple. You just have a hash and you push, just have an array and you push a new value to it. This is really simple. We do it in Ruby a lot, but actually it's not functional because you're updating a variable. So this would be the functional version of it. You're actually creating a new array and adding a new element to it. So when you do this functional stuff, this is really cool because that's when you get parallelism and then you get concurrency. Basically, if you don't do this on Ruby, it will like process the first function, processing the second function, and then sum both. But if you're doing it in a parallel way in a functional language like Elixir, you can actually process both in parallel and then see the work. So basically, one process per core. My machine has 4 cores. I could only have 4 Ruby processes running on it. And this is a quick example of me running an Elixir code on my machine. As you can see, I use almost all 4 cores in full potency. And what I end up doing this here that you just saw is I just run 5 million Elixir processes on it, Erlang processes on it. What is awesome. All right, so pass it. All right. So there's a bunch of things that you can relate to that. So Rake and Bundler, if you like Rails and Ruby, you can have Mix, that's the same thing in Elixir. Genfile, to do dependencies, you can have Mix X. And some examples, like I built the fastest Rails application that I could. This is the response time that I got, 184 milliseconds. And this is the response that I got in Elixir, 233 microseconds. And I want to finish with this slide that is from John Armstrong, the creator of Erlang, when he tried Elixir. And he said, this is good shit. All right? So as I said, I'm writing a book about all this shit. And you can check it at elixir.getarubit.com. And this is it. Thank you so much.